Hey everyone, Metal Yoshi here, and if you haven't seen it already, here's the Mario Golf Toastal Tour speedrun page. There's a lot of great guides, resources, and leaderboards here, so speedrun.com/mgtt. And now is a four-way comparison between Mario, Daisy, Donkey Kong, and Bowser for Rain Attack. As you can see, there's slightly different times it takes for them to select their characters from the menu and to select Rain Attack. Mario's the quickest, obviously, because you don't have to move the character select screen, but it's only a very minor distance that ultimately barely matters. And then the first hole, the rain is just to the left of where you need to go, and DK with his fade requires the least amount of adjustment. The others only require very minimal adjustment. The others play shorter first shots, but longer second shots, but ultimately it almost evens out. I have ace strats for Mario and for Bowser for this hole, whereas not for DK or Daisy, so those two fall slightly behind, but, you know, it doesn't matter all that much, and plus, You could get screwed over by RNG, so that's definitely not something to depend on. And still, for all purposes, each of these characters are relatively created equal. This hole, the routine is pretty simple. You simply go for the rain on the right with a normal unpowered drive, and then to the next one, and then to the third one with a wedge or short iron. You just want to do those as low and quickly as you can for the most part. Then rain here, arch there, the rain is slightly to the left. Mario and Donkey Kong do not require any adjustment to get that rain and can fire straight away, while Mario has to add a fade, but the other two have to take a small amount of time to get that first rain, but it's relatively minor. If you land on the front of the green just right with a low shot and backspin, then the ball will come to a stop very quickly, so that's something that you may be lucky to take advantage of. And then bunker ball, whatever it is. No, you might have to do a small amount of adjustment, especially if you're Donkey Kong, to get the rain. You'll want to play out to the right so that the tree that's in front of the green doesn't get too much in the way as you're going for the flag. Still a relatively straightforward birdie. And then times two is a hole where there's kind of a split off left and right. The left one comes first and then the right, and you need the third shot to get to the green and fourth to sink it. So this one is a little bit harder than the other ones are, where you can pretty much easily get birdie. Yeah, the second shot is very short, so you may want to practice that part a little bit, and then make sure that you don't go crazy on the third shot, because if you miss your putt, then you're not gonna like yourself for it. Pretty much, yeah, around 3 minutes for Lakitu Valley. That's pretty quick, and for the most part, all four of them are generally equal. Now for Cheap Cheap Valley, the waterfall arch. The rain is beyond the tree on the left. Basically, just play a low driver. You know, you may add top spin depending on what kind of character you are. Take a couple of seconds to see what you're doing so that you can hit your second shot close and secure a birdie and move on. The flag can either be at the front or at the back, and there's a pretty significant yardage variation between the two. Skit ski skip. There's a big green on the right that goes across the creek. You'll just want to play out as far and right as you can so that you'll have a low shot through the rain, and depending on how far out you go, you may have anything from a long iron or four wood to a shorter iron. Now, you'll want to make it as short as possible, but if you can control a wood, especially with whatever distance RNG that you get, then all the more power to you. Now, donuts no ponds. This one can be a little bit tricky for beginners the first time. Yeah, you'll just want to play a standard drive to the right and then about three quarters of a drive or so that you're, you know, close to the island with the tree and the rain on it, so that you can scoop it from underneath and be able to secure the birdie. The pin is either on the right, where there's, you know, a lot of slope and can be kind of annoying, or it's on the left where it's relatively flat. So that can definitely introduce variation. So for the most part, the characters are still relatively equal. It is definitely possible for Donkey Kong and Bowser to get the first two rings on the fly, but then their position in the bunker for the third ring is kind of iffy. So it's overall better just to play short and right. And then, you know, a really low fade gets you the rings all at once. Treetop target, the ring is to the left on top of a tree. Obviously those with fades will require the least adjustment, whereas those with draws will require the most, but it's still not a huge difference. With Bowser, you do have to be a little bit careful, because if you're anywhere left of the middle of the ring, then you could actually end up in the water. Flowering arches, simply, you know, get in as close as you can to the left side, so that then you're in a solid position to wrap a draw through both rings toward the green. You know, just take a quick look using either, you know, a flick up of the C stick or the X button to kind of get a gauge of where you're going. Because, you know, that it takes a lot longer to play an extra shot. Now, overall, for the most part, everybody's still equal. Daisy lost time because she missed a long putt at Hunker and Bunkers. Now with the Shifting Sands, Funky Pharaoh is a pretty interesting looking hole. It's kind of a nose ring, if you will. Yeah, just strike the through the ring on the right cheek, and you know, hope you go at least 150 yards. And Donkey Kong and Bowser are both strong enough that they can make the green in two shots. So they probably have the advantage on this hole overall. Sometimes you might be able to get Mario on the green in two, but you need either a really precise fade shot or a good bounce. Rocky rebound. You just play as far up the hill as you can without going over it, and if you have even a decent lie, then you should be able to hit high and far enough to get to the ring. You know, if you want to be safe, then you'll want to hit a higher shot to the ring, but definitely the right height, especially on the low side, might get you a bounce onto the green, which could nag you a birdie, or you can chip in, and either way, you'll be saving time. Pyramid Pinnacle, the ring is to the right after your tee shot, so characters that are able to use a draw have an advantage. I got a bad lie with Mario, so I had to do what I had to do and sacrifice my shot to the green. Somehow failed to make it to the green with Bowser, but managed a couple of chip-ins. So those were good time savers. Calms on High is one of the first quote-unquote, like, holes that can be frustrating and not just difficult. So you'll want to play right and safe over the bunker for the first shot, and then either a straight shot or a slight fade as far as you can go. You'll want to be past the short column so it's not in your way as you're going up. And either way, if the flag is towards the front or if it's towards the back relative to the tee box, then you'll still have a good angle. And you'll want to adjust using backspin or topspin depending on what kind of RNG you get, because you could get a lot. Rain and Ruin, yeah, pretty much a three-quarters three-iron shot, maybe slightly more. And topspin yields a lower bounce. You could do super back. That gets you a higher bounce. It might actually be safer if you plan on doing it that way. You know, you also have room to aim to the right, which might actually be faster. And then Ruins Rings right on. You basically dump a, dump a half drive so that you have a solid angle to play a fade through the first ring, and you're in position for the other two rings. I had a really good stop with Mario and his backspin. Overall on this hole, I think DK has the slight advantage, because if you position him just right, then his fade will go through the last two rings and onto the green at the greatest angle of any of the others, whereas Bowser probably has the toughest time to get to the green. So he had more pars than the others, so he took longer to complete the course, but if you balance out and have the same number of birdies for everybody, then I would think that they would all take about the same time. Dolphin Dreams, this hole can definitely be annoying. It takes a while. Definitely it's not a bad idea to play a draw shot with backspin close to the left edge of the ring where the fast fairway is, and if you do catch the fast fairway, then you might be able to go even further forward so that you'll have, you know, an easier second shot. Or you could play the fast fairway and just kind of roll it so that it doesn't quite go in the bunker. But even if you do land on the bunker in the left, then you may be strong enough to where a forward with power should be able to get you to the right of the final ring and then through to save par. But that is definitely one that you'll want to practice. And then Rocky Rains, there's a group of three rains that are situated over a coral reef. And it's far and away fastest to just go for the rains on the tee shot, but you'll definitely need some adjusting regardless of who you use. The draw characters probably have it easiest, because when they use topspin, the ball will bounce right, which is beneficial as it'll keep you in bounce. Yeah, you'll definitely want to use topspin so that you don't end up bouncing into the water. I had to do a restart with Mario since I messed up the first drive attempt, so now I lose some time with him for the time being. Wacky Weather. Yeah, you'll want to play a low shot, probably about 7/8 of your driver, either a fade or draw, depending on who you are, will do, so that you're in the beach bunker, and then a short iron to the island in front of the following ring will set you up nicely. Yeah, don't be afraid to go for the bunker, actually, on this shot, because otherwise there's not really a whole lot of room to play with. Most of the green is very flat, so you just set yourself up an approach shot, and then allow room for the ball to come short so that you can make up any distance with topspin. That's probably your best way to go about it. Though top of ball can add distance too. So I mean, yeah, Wacky Weather is definitely a pain, and you'll want to practice that one. Snarky Sharky is probably the easiest of the six on this course. You'll just play a drive to the left as much as you can, so that then with a long iron shot, then you'll just go right through the rain, and then pretty simple up and down from there. I had a crazy lucky shot with Bowser, so saved a fair bit of time with him. Floating huts and hoops. This one is very much fade friendly, so Donkey Kong has the advantage. Mario can also muster enough of a fade to be able to get the ring on his drive, whereas Bowser has to improvise, and Daisy, depending on the wind, can barely do it. I lost time with her because of the way that the ball bounced on the wooden gazebo there, so it's kind of unlucky. But otherwise, yes, it is possible for Daisy to get that in one shot too, so she's still overall a viable candidate. And then Heartburn, it's a simple hole, but it's a little bit annoying, because you basically will just need to get all three rings in one precise shot. You might be able to miss one mark and still get them all. And then it's a matter of luck depending on how far your putt is. I kind of derped because I didn't see that the putt slopes at the end. I just whacked the ball straight. Daisy lost that segment, I think, because of some of her unlucky bounces, especially with floating HUD's hoops. But I think overall they all still have a pretty good chance. For this whole warp pipe, I think DK overall has the advantage because the angle of his ball is best suited to landing in the middle of the pipe, which gets you the best bounce. Hopefully you'll want to bounce beyond the brick path that's there, beyond the blue pipe, so that then you have a relatively clear shot with a 3-wood power shot to the green. Otherwise, you'll have to play around and use an extra stroke, and that will cost you some time. Chain chomp caution. Now this is one of the most frustrating holes in the entirety of Rain Attack, and it's definitely much more draw friendly, but Donkey Kong can still manage. You'll want to first play overall position wise, so that you get one ring on the first shot, and then the second and third on the following shot, and then the third shot is the most frustrating part. You'll want to play as high of a shot as absolutely possible, preferably if you still have a power shot, and just use a bunch of backspin if the flag is in the front. But if it's towards the back, then normal backspin will usually suffice, and usually it's better to do bottom of the ball of an approach wedge than to just do a normal sand wedge. But that option can be available to you if you somehow get like plus one or whatever. Big Ba-Bomb. I think I made a mistake with DK here. I believe it should still be possible for him to get to the left side with a high slice miss hit, but I went around instead. Regardless though, every character should be able to get to the Ba-Bomb in two shots. But it's just a matter of setup. So you'll want to practice and master that one. Ring around the Koopa, you'll want to aim right and use a shorter shot that kind of bounces low so that you land on short grass, and then just kind of be careful where you aim, and the ball could bite backward, so you'll want to be kind of aggressive. Mushroom Doom. This hole is a royal pain in the ass. My favorite method for this one is to hit about 3/4 of a drive, and then depending on your lie and the wind and the situation that you have, play a 3-wood or 4-wood power with the bottom of the ball, and scoop the two rings from underneath. You'll want to practice that strat a lot, because it'll kill runs. If the wind is bad, then you'll definitely, it's like a tailwind especially, you may want to consider skipping the hole and doing a different one, or restarting that hole again. And probably backspin is better on the following shot, and then just up and down. Starlight Starbright. Mario and Daisy aren't quite strong enough to make it to the green pipe in one shot, so I just have them play a 3/4 drive to the left, which gives them room to play a nice lofted pitching wedge or 9-iron up to the pipe with minimal issues regardless of the wind. It's fastest to use you're usually given a 3-wood, probably about 80 to 85 yards, but it is risky if you miss a mark, so it is perfectly fine to club down to what's probably a 9-iron or approach wedge as you're going down that hill. With DK and Bowser, with good wind, you can get to the green pipe in one shot, which definitely saves time, but if you're not confident in hitting your marks, or if the wind is uncooperative, then it's perfectly fine to lag just like Mario and Daisy have to. I was quickest with Mario and Daisy because I made relatively few mistakes, whereas I made a significant mistake with Donkey Kong, and with Bowser, it's just I think I took extra time adjusting shots and missed a couple of putts, so fewer chip-ins. So yeah, honestly, all things being equal, they're still close to equal. It's hard to tell. Bowser Badlands, this first whole Bewitched Bridge is not all that hard. You'll want to play a long drive that gets close to the rings, and they're big enough to where you should be able to contort your shot to go through both of them on your second shot. And whether you take a bounce on the fast fairway or, you know, whatever method you use is up to you. I messed up my strat with Donkey Kong, so I had to start the hole over, and that puts him behind already, especially considering that I didn't save birdie there. So maybe it's just my unfamiliarity with Donkey Kong, but otherwise I have no fault with his character. Bowser Jr.'s Breath. This is the worst par 3 in all of Rain Attack, and if the cup is on the left, then well, good luck to you. You'll definitely want to play a longer shot on this island, and then adjust to a fade that'll go around these rings. Donkey Kong can probably do it the most easily. Usually an 8 or 9 iron power shot will work out pretty well. And you'll probably want to be aggressive because the green is easier to work with past the hole than it is in front of the hole. Sorry, Babam. The safe way to do it is to play your drive 200 yards and to the right, and then strike the Babam with a short iron. And you'll want to hit the Babam on the left side so that, you know, and do so gently so that your shot is still in line to the green. Donkey Kong and Bowser both have good chances to bounce on the stone bridge to get the Babam in one shot and save a shot, but again, it really depends because the wind can be strong sometimes. And then the Thwomp Hole, I missed what it was called, but you'll want to play a shot 210 yards to the right that's in line with the rings on the following shot, and then a high driver or three wood, doesn't even really matter where it goes, as long as it goes through all three rings is fine. This hole is not all that difficult with practice. Needle Mound Madness. This one really is just a matter of making sure that you go through both rings one at a time. A full driver will get you through the first ring with minimal issues. And then it's safest usually to club down to a short iron for the second one. Now, depending on where the flag is, either way, you'll probably want to overhit this, because if the cup is in the back, then there's a really weird slope that's kind of like dual slanted in front of it, and you might miss that putt, which would result in you restarting the hole, and that's really bad. That's a volcano. This hole can kill your runs. But what I usually like to do, it really depends. Daisy and Donkey Kong probably have the easiest time, is to play a high fade that loops around onto that fairway platform on the first shot, and then use a high-powered short iron or a long iron, and the four wood to get up to the volcano. Backspin is not going to do so much as you think, so you'll want to be aggressive but not aggressive. And then if it's windy, definitely take the time to gauge what the wind is going to do, because when you're going down 100 yards, the wind does a lot. If you miss the fairway platform on the first shot, then definitely take the time to do a tiny 10-yard escape shot to get out of there. But keep in mind then that from the top of the volcano, you only have two shots to finish the hole, so be very, very careful. Got to wait for DK to finish because he had a very slow start at the Badlands, and that by itself is probably what has caused him in this particular segment to be far behind the others. Yeah, a restart costs a minimum of 10 seconds, probably an average of 15, and then the extra stroke probably costs another 5, so anyway, that wraps up the run itself. And then here's a chart of the stats that I counted, just so that you can keep in mind as far as comparison goes. I got an ace, and then half of the possible birdies, like holes, I got birdies, And then there were chip-ins. I included birdie chip-ins and par chip-ins, because those probably either saved time or didn't save time. And then Mario won out over total time, followed by Bowser, Daisy, and Donkey Kong, but I think all these are absolutely within the realms of error, so I'm going to throw the vote to you. Who did you like best? Be sure to leave a comment, and thanks for watching. I hope that this helped you.